Hello, my name is Scott Tuzina, and I want to know, are you ready for unstoppable fat loss?
Yeah, I went through metabolic hell and back. Yes, I have struggled with obesity from childhood. I simply loved food.
So I tried all different things. You know, and the funny thing is I'm a pretty focused person, and I was really focused on trying to lose weight, but I couldn't make it stick.
I turned around 50 or 51, and I was weighing around 300 pounds.
The thing that gives them trouble is the emotional eating, when they're tired, when they're stressed, when they're bored, when they're lonely, when they're depressed.
You know, I was the kid in high school that was always picked last for the teams and always made fun of.
But I don't ever want anyone to think that due to poor genetics, due to genetics that are less than somebody that may or may not grace a magazine cover, that could be an excuse for them to accept, you know, less than the best for themselves.
High graph of hope for people that say they have bad genetics. All the research shows that only about 18% of your overall total results are due to your genetics. And so everything else is totally within your control. People that say they have bad genetics, it's a cop-out.
The biggest, most common thing that people do mentally is basically give in to fear. And for me, my favorite acronym for the word fear is forever expecting awful results.
People do not realize they are literally sabotaging their own success with the way that most people think about weight loss.
So the key to fat loss must be to eat less and exercise more, right?
The fact that diets never seem to work, you know, go on a diet and maintain control over what I was eating for as long as I could, which was on sometimes an entire day. On other times, it might be for a month or more. And then, of course, when it was over, fall back into the pattern, fall back into the habit, not only gain weight back, but gain more than enough weight, more than what I had lost.
What's really holding us back?
But really, Scott, if you want to know what's holding people back, it's nothing. Nothing is holding you back except your own belief that something is holding you back, whatever that might be. It's beliefs that hold us back, or beliefs are what frees us and it pulls us forward. You know, if you change a belief, you change the way you think. If you change the way you think, you change the way you act. If you change the way you act, you change your results.
But what happens if we fall off the wagon or get off track?
It's not off track. You're on the right track. Most people don't realize that the right track has twists and curves and zigzags in it.
I believe the only way that you can fail is when you let your logic shout down your heart. You let your logic say to your heart, shut up, you'll never do this. That's when you fail because you don't even take the step.
What does it really take to achieve unstoppable fat loss?
Because one of the things I learned is the how-to is all over the place. There's all kind of books. There's free information online. Everybody tells you about what to go do to work out and how to exercise. There's just an avalanche of that. It's confusing. There's so much of that. What I found was missing was the emotional component of support.
The fact that you have a choice to eat good, the fact that you have a choice to go to the gym and have unstoppable fat loss, that is possible.
When you get a strong enough why, you can tolerate any how.
But you need to know who you are inside and all of the wonderful, you know, characteristics and attributes that you have. You know, and you can't let anybody deter you or hold you back from doing what you want to, what you ultimately want to do.
I had to have something that was much larger than myself as a goal and a vision. Otherwise, my mind just would not latch on to the traditional, you really should be healthier, John. You really should lose weight because you'll feel better.
And then the thought came, wait a minute, this is a new Joe. This is the Joe who wants to be slim and trim. This is the Joe who wants to be fit.
You know what really separates the people with the unstoppable attitude from the people who don't is when it becomes a part of you, when it becomes a part of your identity, when you say, I am an unstoppable person.
But it's just a matter of you wanting to change and really thinking about, you know, why you want to change and then really taking massive and immediate action.
With anything that you do, you might as well just freaking go for the best, the absolute best with it.
Believe in yourself. Even if that's just so hard to do and you don't think there's any way you can.
Succeeding on purpose is when you realize you're responsible and you're in control. You choose. You set the sails. You're steering the ship.
Every single woman can become fit and shapely and beautiful.
Now is the time to go after what you want. Now is the time to get the body of your dreams. Right now. Now is the time to work on yourself and to become more and to grow more. This is what it's all about, becoming better than you were yesterday. Life is about growth.
So would you like to know what separates the people who achieve fat loss success from the people who continue to struggle to lose weight? simply visit www.unstoppablefatloss.com. I look forward to seeing you there and to share in your successful fat loss journey. Take care.